Hello everyone, my name is Shoaib Chauhan, PhD scholar from Division of Vegetable Science, IIT New Delhi. Today is the 10th class of lecture series which I have started for the students who are preparing for JRF and SRF exam. And if you have not watched the previous lectures, I have provided the link in the description section. Please go and watch that videos. And today we are going to discuss the legume crops. I will prepare two lectures on legume crop. In first lecture, we will discuss about garden pea, French bean and cowpea. In second part of legume crops, we will discuss about the remaining legume crops. So let's start the lecture. Here I have listed the different legume species. In this, you have to remember the botanical name, chromosome number and origin. You can take screenshot of this. The unique thing I want to tell you is that the difference between the botanical name of garden pea and field pea is, in garden pea is Pyrum sativum, subspecies hortens, while the field pea is garden Pyrum sativum arvens. You have to remember the garden pea. Garden means hortens, horticulture, and field pea you can remember arvens. You can remember arvens with the name of Arvind. Okay, and now the in case of chromosome number, most of the legume crop are having chromosome number 22, except garden pea, cluster bean, and broad bean. In garden pea, chromosome number is 14. In cluster bean, also the chromosome number is 14. And in case of broad bean, faba bean, the chromosome number is 12, which is lowest among the legume crop. In case of origin, legume crop, Central Asia is regarded as the birthplace of all legume crop. And most of the legume crop are originated from Central Asia or Africa, except French bean, lima bean, which they have originated from French bean from southern Mexico. And lima bean is from Guatemala, and jack bean is from Mexico, and soya bean from China. Now the day length requirement of different legumes: garden pea, French bean, lima bean, cowpea. These are day neutral plants, and cluster bean, Indian bean, and winged bean. These are short day plants. Okay, you have to remember. Here I have defined the day neutral, long day, and short day plant. Day neutral plant, the flowering is not depend or affected by the day length. In case of long day plant flower under only the long day condition, day length more than 14 hours. Short day plant flower only flower under short day condition, that is the day length less than 14 hours. Most of the legume crops are self pollinated except the lima bean. Lima bean is often cross pollinated crop. In legume crop, the most of the legume crop are self-pollinated due to the mechanism of chasmogamy and cleistogamy. In chasmogamy, flower is open only after the pollination and fertilization. But in case of cleistogamy, flower never open. Means ultimately the self-pollination is there. Example of cleistogamy is fenugreek. Now the first legume crop we are going to discuss is garden pea. Garden pea having botanical name Pyrum sativum, subspecies hortens, and field pea is subspecies arvens. Family is Leguminosae, and chromosome number is 14. Origin of the garden pea is Central Asia, and progenitor you have to remember is Pyrum sativum elatius. And garden pea is used as vegetable and also used as a forage and green manure crop. And garden pea is rich in protein, carbohydrate, and vitamin. Whole potted sugar pea can be eaten as pod, means sugar pea. In sugar pea, we can eat whole pod because its pod are less fibrous. And India is second largest producer of garden pea after China. Area of garden pea cultivation in India is 0.55 million hectare and production is 5.56 million tons. UP is top first in area and production of garden pea, then MP, Punjab, and Jharkhand. Flower color of garden pea is purple or white. Fruit type is pod. And garden pea seed viability you have to remember is 2 to 3 years. Garden pea is self-pollinated crop, we know, and isolation distance follow in seed production of garden pea is 25 to 50 meter, 25 for certified field seed production and 50 for foundation seed production. Garden pea varieties are grouped on the basis of plant growth habit, seed surface, and pod maturity. In case of plant growth habit, cultivars are bush, medium tall, and tall. Based on seed surface, cultivars are smooth seeded or round seeded and wrinkle seeded likewise. And in garden pea, green pods are in early maturing variety, the pods are ready for first picking in 50 days after So in case of mid and late maturing cultivar, the pods are ready for harvest in 60 to 65 days and 70 to 75 days respectively. In garden pea, the early sown crop, remember this point, it is important. The early sown crop is suffer from wilt and pea stem fly, while the late sown crop is suffer from powdery mildew disease. I will repeat, early sown crop suffer from wilt and pea stem, and late crop is suffer from powdery mildew disease. In garden pea, wrinkle seeded cultivars are more tolerant to low temperature as compared to round seeded cultivar. Now some species in garden pea. The edible potted pea is Pisum sativum microcarpa. In edible potted pea, there are two types, snap pea and snow pea. Snap pea, the pod are thick, having thick wall, and snow pea, the pod having thin wall. Edible potted peas are originated from spontaneous mutation. Pea aphid is a serious pest which causes curling of leaves and pod. Leafless pea, it is important point, is resistant to foliar diseases, tolerant to water logging, and suitable for mechanical harvesting. In garden pea, the powdery mildew resistance is governed by two recessive genes. It may ask in exam, it is important. The one gene is ER and other is ER2. In garden pea, Fusarium wilt resistance is governed by single dominant gene. There are two races of Fusarium wilt in garden pea, race 1 and 2. The genes are FNW for race 1, FW for race 2. In garden pea varieties, the average weight of 100 seed varies between 15 to 25 grams. Mutation breeding in garden pea is common because the seed of garden pea are able to withstand and able to produce stable mutant after chemical mutagenic treatment. Therefore, we know that mutation breeding is more common as compared to the other vegetable crops. The intensive research work is undertaken on garden pea breeding for disease and pest resistant at Jawaharlal Nehru Krishi Vishwavidyalaya, Jabalpur, MP. And leafless mutant, it is important point, the leafless mutant is having genetic constitution AF, AF, ST, ST. The leafless mutant genotype of P is produced as at JNKVB, Jabalpur. JP3 brown 3 and 4 are rust resistant varieties of garden pea. Kinnauri is a cultivar resistant to Ascochata blight disease. Now, garden pea varieties. First is early maturing varieties. Arkel is introduced from UK. Please remember the varieties who are introduced from other countries. Arkel is from UK. It escaped the attack of powdery mildew disease because it is an early sown variety. Jawar Matar 3 and 4 are developed through hybridization method and their seed are wrinkle shaped. Early Badger is suitable for canning. It is resistant to Fusarium wilt disease and tolerant to heat and drought. Little Marvel is a variety. It is a dwarf thick stem variety. Early December, it is a dwarf variety developed through hybridization. Alaska is a first early maturing variety suitable for canning. Meteor is an early maturing variety. Asauji is developed by selection. It is an early dwarf round seeded variety. Early Subar is a dwarf introduced variety from England. Harbhajan is an extra early maturing variety. It is resembled to field pea and highly susceptible to powdery mildew. Now, other early maturing varieties are Pusa Pragati, it is resistant to powdery mildew. Kashi Nandani is tolerant to leaf miner and pod borer. Kashi Udal and Kashi Mukti are also early maturing variety. Kashi Mukti is resistant to powdery mildew. Other early maturing variety of garden peas are Mataragada 6, 7, Kelvin Wonder, Pant Matar 2 and Early Giant. Now, mid and late maturing varieties of garden pea. Arka Sampurna is a whole potted pod edible variety. It is resistant to rust and powdery mildew. Arka Karthik and Arka Ajit are resistant to powdery mildew and rust. Bonovillae is a mid maturing variety introduced from USA. It is having small size and dark black color pod. Haparkheda is a popular variety grown in MP. It is a double potted variety. Double potted variety means on single node, two pods will be developed. Lincoln is a late sowing variety. It is popular in Meerut and Amritsar area. It is used for canning. Dilwich Commando, it is a prolific bearer resistant to common wilt and near wilt disease. Alterman is a variety most suitable for growing in Kachan garden. Jawar Mutter 2 is having better keeping quality and suitable for distance transportation. And Jawar Mutter 71 is resistant to powdery mildew. Jawar P 15 is resistant to powdery mildew and fusarium wilt. Pantu Upar, it is tolerant to pea stem fly. VL Mutter 6 is moderately tolerant to cold and moisture stress condition. UT 1, it is developed by pure line selection and it is resistant to white fly. Palam Priya is tolerant to powdery mildew, and Solan Nero Garden Pea is resistant to powdery mildew. Now, new varieties of garden pea: Pusa Prabal, Pusa Shri, Pusa Arka Chaitra, Arka Uttam, Arka Tapas, Arka Mayur, and Arka Priya. Pusa Prabal, it is a dual resistant variety resistant to fusarium wilt and powdery mildew disease. It is having high shelling percentage. Pusa Shri is extra early maturing variety resistant to fusarium wilt. Arka Chaitra, it is a tall variety tolerant to high temperature. Arka Uttam, Arka Tapas are also tolerant to high temperature. Arka Mayur, it is suitable for Kharif and Rabi season. Arka Priya is resistant to powdery mildew and rust. Edible potted varieties of garden pea are Sylvia and UN53. UN53 is a variety developed at IIHR Bangalore. Mutant varieties of garden pea, these are important. Mutant varieties are Sarla, KP829, R701, 710, and JP67, JP251A, 625, 997, and 999. Okay. Now, the reason why the F1 hybrid in garden pea are not popular. The reason are from single crops, the number of seeds are produced are less as compared to the solanaceous crop. In garden pea, the per cross number of seeds are 6 to 7, but in case of solanaceous crop, the per crop the seed will be 1000 to 2000. And in garden pea, crossing is not easy because of the floral structure, and making manual crosses is laborious and time consuming. And garden pea are having a high seed rate, therefore the cost of seeds will increase, hybrid seed will increase directly. And in garden pea, heterosis is not as much required for the hybrid. Now, the difference between garden pea and field pea are, you can take screenshot, I will explain the few points from this only. We will start from the botanical name. In garden pea, I have already told that it is Pisum sativum hortens, and field pea is Pisum sativum arvens. Flower color in garden pea is white, in case of field pea it is purple. Wing or keel is white in garden pea, and in case of field pea it is purplish red. Wing or keel is actually a corolla in case of flower. In my exam they may ask what is actually keel, is what, which part of flower. It is a corolla. Large size pod is there in garden pea, small size pod is there in field pea. Seeds are bold, and in case of garden pea, seeds are small in case of field pea. And more sugar is there in garden pea, low sugar is there in field pea. You can take screenshot. Now, climate and soil. It is a cool season crop, grow best at mean monthly temperature of 10 to 18 degrees Celsius. For garden pea, the optimum temperature for seed germination is 22 degrees Celsius. Please remember this, 22 degrees Celsius. But the higher temperature in garden pea affect pollination, seed setting, and reduce the pod quality and yield. And it increase the conversion of sugar into hemicellulose and starch. And garden pea thrive best on well-drained, loess and friable loamy soil. Lighter soil is good for early crop, and heavy soil is good for late and for high yielding. Sowing time is very important in garden pea, because the early sown crop is suffer from wilt and stem fly, while the late sown crop is suffer from powdery mildew. Generally, in North Indian plains, the garden pea is sown in October to mid-November. Peninsular India, the sowing of garden pea is in June-July. In hills, the sowing time is March for summer and May for autumn crop. The seed rate for early, please remember this, for early varieties, it is 100 to 120 kg per hectare. For mid and late varieties, the seed rate is 80 to 90 kg per hectare. Now, spacing. Early cultivars are spacing is 30 by 5 to 10 cm. In case of mid and late maturing varieties, spacing is 45 by 10 cm. The depth of seed sowing in garden pea is 2.5 cm. Now, irrigation. If soil moisture is not sufficient before sowing, and pre-sowing irrigation should be given. In legume crops, unlike other crops, the irrigation should not be given after the sowing because there is a problem of seed rotting due to excess of moisture. To obtain good yield in garden pea, the irrigation should be given at most critical stages, which are pod set and green filling stages, and staking of tall cultivar. Tall varieties of garden pea need training and staking. The training should be done in the direction of wind because due to that the damage due to wind is less. Now harvesting, yield and storage. The pod should be harvested at right tender right stage. Delay in harvesting will lead to reduction in pod quality. In garden pea, early varieties are ready for harvest in 50 days, while mid and late cultivar are ready for first picking 6 to 65 days and 70 to 75 days respectively. At the pod maturity, the color of pod changes from dark green to light green and pods are filled with seeds. Tendrometer is used to detect the pod maturity in garden pea. Generally in garden pea, 4 to 5 pickings are required. It may ask in exam that how many pickings are required in garden pea. On an average, the pod yield in garden pea is 2.5 to 4 tons per hectare for early, 6 to 7 for mid, and 8 to 10 tons per hectare for late maturing crop. Garden pea is stored at 0 degree Celsius, and in garden pea, the pod will be freeze at minus 10 degree Celsius. Now, disease and pest of garden pea are powdery mildew, rust, near wilt, root rot, ascochyta blight. I have also mentioned the genetics of disease resistance in different disease of garden pea. The powdery mildew resistance is governed by two recessive genes in garden pea, which are ER and ER2. It is important, it may ask an exam. Rust resistance in garden pea is governed by single dominant gene. Near wilt disease is governed by single, resistance is governed by single dominant gene, FNW. For wilt, caused by Fusarium maxiflorum PC, is governed by single dominant gene, FW. For ascochyta blight, resistance is governed by single dominant gene and duplicate gene H. And now pest of garden pea are pea stem fly, aphid, leaf miner and pod borer. Now the second legume crop we are going to discuss is French bean. French bean having a botanical name Phaseolus vulgaris. Common name are important in legumes crop. The common name of French bean are common bean, kidney bean, haricot bean, snap bean, navy bean, fara bean, and it is called as rajma when we use French bean as a dry seed. Family is leguminaceae and chromosome number is 22. Origin of French bean is southern Mexico and progenitor is important, you have to remember Phaseolus arborigines. The French bean is grown for its tender pod and dry seed purpose. And in French bean, 94% of portion is edible. Dried bean of is rich in protein as compared to meat. There are three types of cultivar in French bean based on growth habit. First is bush type, semi-pole and pole type. Most of the French bean varieties are day-neutral in nature, except the semi-pole type, which are short den type. It is more important point, please remember. China is largest producer of French bean. Fruit type is pod, and French bean is a self-pollinated crop with shallow root system. In India, the French bean is mostly grown for its tender pod, but in USA, it is grown on large scale for processing. Out of four Phaseolus species which are listed here, only Phaseolus coccineus, which is a runner bean, is cross-pollinated in nature. Please remember this. And YCD1 is a dual-purpose variety of French bean. VL Boni 1 is resistant to rust. Bountiful is a variety of French bean introduced from USA. And it's this cultivar, the pod are born on main stem in cluster. French bean crop is susceptible to both excess and water stress condition. Now, physiological disorder are important in French bean. It may ask in exam. First is blossom drop and ovule abortion in French bean is caused due to high temperature. The soil moisture below 12% enhances cracking of cotyledon down in French bean. Calcium deficiency in French bean leads to hypocotyl rotting or necrosis. The Phaseolus species tolerant to salinity is Phaseolus filiformis. The species tolerant to drought is Phaseolus acutifolius. In French bean, the low content of calcium in feed is due to calcium and magnesium deficiency. Important point is that hemagglutinin is toxic substance present in French bean. Please remember. Now varieties of French bean. First is bush type. Pusa parvati is a mutant variety developed by using X-ray. Please remember. And it is resistant to mosaic and powdery mildew. Contender is tolerant to powdery mildew and mosaic. Jampa is introduced from Mexico and resistant to wilt and withstand under warm condition. Pant Anupam is resistant to rust. Pant Bean 2 is resistant to rust and common bean mosaic. And Arca Anup is resistant to rust and bacterial blight. Arca Suvida is photo-insensitive cultivar. Arca Komal, it is good for transport and having excellent cooking quality. Arca Sharat, it is a photo-insensitive variety. Arca Jun is resistant to mung bean yellow mosaic virus. Kashi Sampan, it is less material variety and having high yield. Kashi Rajhans, it is tolerant to high temperature. Arca Bolt, it is resistant to bacterial wilt. Giant Stringless is introduced from Sweden. Now, old type cultivars of French bean. Arca Sukumal, it is resistant to rust and suitable for both Kharif and Rabi season. Lakshmi is important variety. It is resistant to angular leaf spot disease. Hussain Lata and Chuke Wonder are also pole type. Tweed Wonder, it is resistant to anthracnose. Other pole type cultivar of French bean are Swarnalata, Phule Surekha and Phule Suyash. Now, climate and soil. Most of the French bean varieties are day neutral except semi-pole type, which is a short day in condition. It is a cool season crop but thrive at the optimum temperature range between 15 to 25 degrees Celsius. And French bean is grown on soil ranges from light sandy loam to clay loam soil, but water logging condition is not suitable. The optimum pH is 5.3 to 6. Sowing is done in two seasons. The sowing time are July, September, or October, and second crop sown in January to February. In hills, sowing done in March, May. Seed head are important in legume crops. The seed head in French bean, in case of bush type cultivar, is 65 kg per hectare. In case of pole type, it is 25 to 30 kg per hectare. Spacing is 45 to 60 cm by 10 to 15 cm. Inoculation with rhizobium is important in legume crop. Water management. French bean is yellow rooted crop and water state condition greatly affect the pod yield and quality. 6 to 7 on an average irrigation are required for good yield in French bean. Flowering and pod development are most critical stages for irrigation. Now harvesting and yield. French bean are tender pods are harvested means for first picking pods are ready in 45 days after sowing. The pods are ready in 7 to 12 days after flowering. In exam, it may ask that in French bean, after how many days of flowering, the pods are ready for harvesting. The answer is 7 to 12 days after flowering. Pods should be harvested at tender stage and delay in harvesting will lead to the pod become rough and fibrous. Average pod yield in bush type is 8 to 10 tons per hectare. In case of pole type, the yield is 12 to 15 tons per hectare. Please remember that in case of bush type cultivar, seed rate is high but yield is low. But in case of pole type, the seed rate is less and yield is high. In French bean, the maturity indices used for to judge the pod harvesting stages, pod size, percentage of seed, dry matter content, and alcohol insoluble solids. Please remember the maturity indices of French bean, alcohol insoluble solid ASI. Now, disease and pest of French bean are anthracnose, rust, bean yellow mosaic, Rhizoctonia root rot, dry rot, phyllodi, and ashy stem blight. The phyllodi is disease you have to remember because it is caused due to unique causal organism amylose. Amylose means mycoplasma like organism. The phyllodi disease is also found in radish. The pests are stem fly, thrips, hairy caterpillar, and serpentine leaf miner. Now the third legume crop which we are going to discuss is cowpea. Cowpea botanical name Vigna unguiculata variety unguiculata. Common name are important. The common name are southern bean, China pea, lobia in Hindi, black eye pea, and kathir pea. Family is leguminaceae and chromosome number is 22. Origin is Central Africa. A trypsin inhibitor, it is an important part. It is a toxic substance present in peas and beans. International cowpea breeding work is carried out at International Institute of Tropical Agriculture, IITA, Ibadan, Nigeria. Please remember this point. Progenitor is also important. Progenitor is Vigna angulata variety mesenthyl. The asparagus bean, yard long bean is Vigna angulata sesquipedalis. The pulse type copy is Vigna angulata variety radiata. The dual purpose copy is variety cylindrica. Cardjung bean is Vigna sinensis variety cylindrica. The species resistant to pod borer is Vigna angulata biflora. In India, coffee grown throughout the year, and it is grown for both tender pods and dry seed. It is also used for green manure and fodder. It is mainly a rainy season crop. Coffee is a day neutral in nature and having shallow root system. Coffee is self-pollinated crop and flower color is white. Konkan Wali is a variety of yard long bean. Now varieties. Pusa Komal, it is resistant to bacterial blight. Pusa Sokomal, it is highly resistant to golden yellow mosaic virus and leaf spot disease. Pusa Rituraj is important variety. It is dual purpose variety. Pusa Varsati is for rainy season. Pusa Do Fasli, it is for both summer, spring and rainy season. Arka Green, it is tolerant to heat and moisture stress. It is important variety. Arka Samruddhi, its flesh are without parchment layer. Therefore, it is having good cooking qualities. Arka Mangla, plant is very tall and pod are very long and stringless. Arka Suman, pod is without parchment. That's why it is good, having good cooking quality. Arka Garima is tolerant to heat and low moisture stress. Bidan Barbati is resistant to coffee mosaic and coffee golden mosaic virus. Introduced varieties of coffee are Philippines early and yard long bean. Now IHR varieties. Kashi Nidhi, Kashi Sudha, Kashi Kanchan, Kashi Gauri and Kashi Unnadi are IHR varieties. Kashi Nidhi having seed color reddish brown and it is having good keeping quality and suitable for distant marketing. Kashi Sudha is tolerant to golden mosaic virus and cercospora leaf spot. Kashi Kanchan is suitable for both season. Kashi Gauri and Unnati are resistant to golden mosaic and leaf spot, cercospora leaf spot. Now climate and soil. Coffee is a hardy crop, comes well under rainfall condition. Coffee can grow on wide range of soil, but soil should have adequate drainage. Coffee is chiefly grown in two seasons, one is summer spring, other is rainy season. In mild climatic condition, coffee can be grown throughout the year. Seed rate is important, which is 25 kg per hectare. Rhizobium inoculation, as I have told you, it is a very important in legume crop. Spacing in rainy season 45 to 60 by 15 cm. For summer spring, the spacing is less because the growth is less as compared to rainy season. It is 30 to 35 by 15 cm. To obtain good yield in cowpea, the irrigation, critical irrigation stages are flowering and pod development stages. Harvesting and yield picking of tender pods started 45 days after sowing. Delay in harvesting will lead to over mature and fibrous pod. Average pod yield in cowpea is 5 to 8 tons per hectare and average seed yield is 12 to 15 quintal per hectare. Now disease and pest of cowpea. Diseases are cercospora leaf spot, rust, powdery mildew and anthracnose. Pests are pod borer, aphid and plant hopper. This much is for part 1 of legume crop. In part 2, we will discuss about cluster bean, Indian, lima, broad and winged bean. And don't forget to like, subscribe and share with your friends who are preparing for this exam. Take care and be safe, and thank you.